is with me right here at the table. Aliyu Ilias is a customer service expert. Welcome to you, Aliyu, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
How should we greet today or this week?
It's always happy customer service week.
Okay, it's always happy customer service.
Happy customer service week.
Service week. You know, some places I go to, especially like when you go to the bank, some banks though, you know, like, oh, how can I help? How can I be of service to you? Or even some places you enter, how can I be of service to you? How important is this week really?
Very, very important. This week is specifically made to actually look at the importance of customer service in every business. In your business, how important is customer service, and how well do you make sure these people that are attending to people are well treated? So this week specifically is for customer service representatives. One, they are to be celebrated because they face a lot of things: emotional abuse, verbal abuse, physical abuse. That's one. Then more so, if you look at the importance of customer service, it shows in your bottom line. If you attend to people very well, and you really package this both internal customer service and external customer service, definitely it will reflect in your profit base. So it's very, very important.
How powerful is the power of service?
Right.
Let me put it that way, because the theme of this year's Customer Service Week is the power of service.
Right.
So how significant is the power of service? I know you said it to show your bottom line.
Right.
But are there other things that, you know, you can get as a result of
Let me just use a good example of what happened recently, the pandemic. The pandemic has shows a lot of things about service delivery and power of service. Now, people have low purchasing power. So now, if you are not giving people a good service, a good experience, they will definitely move to the next company. Now, most companies are out of business simply because of poor service delivery. Because as a Nigerian now,
it may not be only so.
Is majorly, it's more of like that now, because people want to buy, we want to value for the money. So when the value for the money sets in, you look at service delivery and the experience you get from that. So it's very, very important. More so, the reason for power of service for this year is basically because of still COVID-19 and how this customer service representative need to work remotely. So most of them are working from their home. And when you're working from home, it has its own challenge itself. Maybe perhaps we expect everyone to be family person. Your children are there, you know, husband, wife. You need to attend to a lot of things. Why you still serve customers? And also, during this period, most people are not going to work and are working remotely. They are more tense. So as a customer experience person, you are expected to bring them to a neutral state where they will feel loved and you share a lot of loving messages, so that they can really feel as if you are still in that office attending to them. So these are what come together to really inform the decision to have this theme, powers of service.
Let's take a look at offline service, customer service, and online customer service.
Right.
You've mentioned, of course, because of the pandemic, a lot of businesses also went remote.
Right.
You know, and remote service could be different from the traditional service. You
Very
come to
different.
An office, you get to the reception and all of that. How can companies and individuals that are watching that own businesses, how can, you know, they do better in customer service? Our office here, we have a reception.
Right.
Yes, we have a reception. So how can, you know, they be of service? How can that service be better, both traditional and online?
Well, looking at it, it's a two-way thing. If you look at it, our physical service delivery is always much more difficult compared to online. But online is much more sensitive than physical service delivery. Now, let's look at online. If you speak to a customer representative and that person is speaking on top of his voice, it has meaning in service delivery. Simply means the whole work of that organization is on that person's head and it's reflecting the way that person is approaching the service delivery. Second, if you talk to that such person and it's quite low in the voice, right? It also reflects that maybe the pay is very, very poor. It's based on research. Perhaps the voice speech has to
the modulation
is very, very key. So that's that for online. Because perhaps if you smile on the phone, people know. If you don't, it's also show. Don't think because they are not seeing you. The way you interact with people get to see and watch and listen to how you interact.
How about for those that write, if you don't necessarily speak? Because we see that a lot of businesses are on social media, for example.
Right.
For example, on Instagram, people that do sales, they put the their products on there. I've seen a lot of people also complain, how can you put like a bag you're selling on an Instagram page or a social media page, and you don't even put the amount there?
Right, right.
Do you understand? And when they ask you, you start typing, and you're not typing, you're typing not politely. So what's the difference?
Now, how can... when you are typing, it also has its own tone. Mm. Because it's a marketing strategy itself. You know, you are selling. So for you to sell, you must work on people's intuition. So by working on people's intuition, you need to prepare yourself. More so, there's what we call product knowledge. You that is selling to me should have adequate product knowledge and also express it in a plain manner that I understand. Because you have to look at the category of people you are selling to. And from there, you can now package your advert. If you are selling to me and you do not fix your price, I'll push it to you. Push you one side, I go to the next person.
Because
the joy of it is that you can window shop everywhere now.
Yes.
So what you sell, and that person is also selling the same. Perhaps before I even come to you, I've checked around. So if you disappoint me, I move on to the next person. Okay. But for physical customer experience, it's quite difficult because we measure a lot of things in that. Therein, you measure process. You measure product knowledge, like I said. You measure turnaround time. You measure ambience. You see, so look at, if you look at that thing, it's about five things that you are looking together to determine if this person actually served me well. And lastly, attitude.
Attitude.
Very, very key.
Okay, I think we'll leave it at that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I've been speaking with Aliyu Ilias, who is a customer service expert. This week is Customer Service Week, so I hope you've been of great service and of better service to your customers, especially those of you that have businesses and perhaps companies. Thank you all for being a part of the show this week. I hope I've been of service to you too.
You are indeed.
So please join us again at, okay, tomorrow. No, tomorrow I'll be resting. Next week. You're not going to see me here tomorrow, but you'll see me on Monday, God willing, and next week. So be the best you can be and be the change that you want to see. I am Nancy Naji. Bye now. We'll be right back.